The four values produced are x, y, z, and w. These are called homogeneous coordinates, and they're used for projection. What we do next with these coordinate values is divide each value by the w of the coordinate. This is called the perspective divide, or homogeneous divide. So, for our three test points, we had a value such as 0, 0, negative 1, 1. Dividing by 1 is simple enough. That gives us 0, 0, negative 1. We don't need to bother writing out the w value in the result, since w divided by w will always equal 1. For our next point, w is 11. Dividing all these coordinates by 11 gives 0, 1, 1. Our last point is a little more interesting. Dividing through by w gives us 0, 0.67, 0.83. Here are plots of the original points in view space and their corresponding new locations. Notice that the negative z-axis is pointing to the right for the frustum, and the resulting axis is plus z to the right. Look at what's happened with these points and where they're transformed. They started inside or on the edge of our frustum. After the projection matrix is applied and division by w is performed, the resulting points are in normalized device coordinates. Anything in the range negative 1 to 1 for x, y, and z is in the visible view volume. Let's take another example to show what happens to three objects that are the same size in world space, but at different distances. When we transform to normalized device coordinates, the relative area of coverage of the near plane stays the same. That is, the close object was half as high as the screen in our frustum view and transforms to half the height in NDC space. The second object is farther away and shows up as smaller. The third object on the back of the frustum is indeed much smaller than the others in normalized device coordinates. You might have noticed an interesting thing has happened to the depth of the second object. It started in the middle, but it's moved backwards. We'll talk more about that in a bit, as it's important.